Dear students, in the previous class, we were discussed about the Rolle's theorem. So, statement of the Rolle's theorem was, suppose that y is equal to f of x is continuous at every point of this closed interval a comma b and differentiable at every point of its interior a comma b. So, if f of a is equal to f of b, then there is at least one number c in a comma b at which f dash of c is equal to 0. So, that is the statement of Rolle's theorem. So, now we shall see one note in that now the hypothesis of Rolle's theorem are essential. So, that f of x is continuous and differentiable at every point as well as differentiable at every point of its interior. So, that are the hypothesis of the Rolle's theorem. So now the note the hypothesis of Rolle's theorem are essential. If they fail at even one point, that may be in some point it may be it may not be differentiable or it may not be continuous. So at that time that function is may not have a horizontal tangent. Even one point, then the graph may not have a horizontal tangent. Observe that I will consider one function y is equal to f of x. Now in this function, now if I may draw the graph of this function is discontinuous at one this point. So therefore this is a discontinuous at an end point of a comma b. So therefore this graph has no horizontal tangent. Similarly, observe that in this graph now, this function is discontinuous at an interior point of a comma b. Here it is at an end point at a, this function is not continuous. Similarly, in this function now, at an interior point inside the closed interval a comma b, this function is not continuous. So therefore, this graph also may not have a horizontal tangent. If I may consider the next case now, see here, if I may consider y is equal to f of x, I may draw the graph of this here now, this function is continuous closed interval a comma b, continuous on closed interval a comma b, and this function is non-differentiable at an interior point. This function is non-differentiable. So at that time also, this graph has no horizontal tangent. So this is the three cases has no horizontal tangent. Now let us see example here. Example 1, horizontal tangents of a cubic polynomial. In that now, first we shall consider the polynomial. The polynomial function f of x is equal to x cube by 3 minus 3x. So now, we draw the graph of this function. So observe that graph of this function f of x is equal to x cube by 3 minus 3x. Observe that here, at the point minus 3 and 3, that touches the x-axis, 0 here. So, if I may draw like this, observe that as predicted by Rolle's theorem, this curve has a horizontal tangent. Observe that at these two points, this function has a horizontal tangents between the points where it crosses the x-axis. So, now for that, now observe that given function is continuous. Observe that x cube by 3 minus 3x is continuous and this function is differentiable at every point of minus 3 and 3. Now I will consider just f of minus 3, first point of the closed interval. So replace x by minus 3. So we will obtain minus 3 cube by 3 minus 3 into minus 3. So at that time minus 9 plus 9 is equal to 0. And if I may consider x as plus 3, so that is f of 3, that is equal to 3 cube by 3 minus 3 into 3. So at that time also we will get 9 minus 9 as 0. Observe that f of minus 3 as well as f of 3 is equal to 0. Given function is continuous on closed interval minus 3 and 3 as well as this function is differentiable at every point of open interval minus 3 comma 3 and f of minus 3 and f of 3 is equal to 0. So now we can apply the Rolle's theorem here. Therefore, by Rolle's theorem, f dash must be 0 at least one point. So at least one point f dash must be 0. So observe that now f dash of x is equal to, first f of x is x cube by 3 minus 3x. For that now f dash of x is 3x square by 3 minus 3, 3, 3 will get cancels. F dash of x is equal to x square minus 3. So now what? This f dash of x is 0. At what point? F dash of x is 0 at x square minus 3 is equal to 0, or x square is equal to 3, or x may be plus or minus root 3. Observe that this f dash of x is 0 at x is equal to either plus root 3 or minus root 3. Now look at the graph now. At minus 3, this function gives again 0. So that is the root of f of x. Again here also at plus 3. X is equal to plus or minus root 3 we will obtain here. So now when x is plus root 3, we will get y as minus 2 times root 3. Observe that when x is plus root 3, we will get y as minus 2 root 3. And when x is minus root 3, we will obtain y as plus 2 times root 3. Then draw the graph. At these two points now, we obtain horizontal tangent to this given polynomial. So therefore, given function has two horizontal tangents. Now, let us see the one more example. Example number 2. Solution of an equation f of x is equal to 0. Solution of an equation f of x is equal to 0. In that now, show that the equation x cube plus 3x plus 1 is equal to 0 has exactly one real solution. We have to show that now x cube plus 3x plus 1 is equal to 0 has exactly one real solution. So I will just consider this x cube plus 3x plus 1 as y or f of x. So f of x is equal to x cube plus 3x plus 1. So then f dash of x can be 3x square plus 3. So now observe that f dash of x is never 0. Observe that here. F dash of x we obtained as 3x square plus 3. Now this f dash of x is never 0 because in the RHS observe that each term is positive, and again if I may consider x value as 0, again I will get f dash of x as 3, so that is not equal to 0. If I may consider any negative value for x, here it is x square. So squaring that gives again positive value. So we obtain in the RHS as positive only. Again, if we may consider any positive value for this x value, again we will get x value. So therefore f dash, again we will get here positive value. So therefore this f dash of x is never 0 because it is always positive. So now if I may consider, there were even two points I will consider, x is equal to a and x is equal to b, where f of x was 0. Now I will consider two points, x is equal to a and x is equal to b. At that point f of x is 0. So now Rolle's theorem, observe that given function is continuous, differentiable, and at two points this function is equal to 0. So now we can apply the Rolle's theorem. Observe that. So Rolle's theorem. So by using the statement of the Rolle's theorem, we can say that this Rolle's theorem would guarantee the existence of a point x is equal to c in between a and b. Now this Rolle's theorem guarantees the existence of a point c in between a and b where f dash was 0. So but this is not possible in this case. Why? Because this f dash of x is never 0. Here, if we may to consider two points x is equal to a and x is equal to b such that their f values are 0, then by using the Rolle's theorem, that gives one point c such that at that point f dash is 0. This is not possible because f dash of x is never 0. So that's what implies. This implies this f has no more than one zero. Only at one point this function f of x is zero. So it does in fact have only one zero, because the intermediate value theorem tells us that the graph of y is equal to f of x crosses the x-axis somewhere between x is equal to minus 1 when y is equal to minus 3 and x is equal to 0 when y is equal to 1. So by looking at the graph here, observe that your function is x cube plus 3x plus 1. If I may consider x value as 1, we will obtain y value as 5. If I may consider x as value as 0, we will get in y value as 1. Again, if I may consider x as minus 1, I will get y as a minus 3. Now draw the graph of this. Observe that this curve crosses the x-axis at only one point. So now that point is the solution of given equation. Observe that only one point this function crosses the x-axis. So that point is the exact real solution of a given equation. The only real zero of the polynomial y is equal to x cube plus 3x plus 1 is the one shown here in the graph here, where the curve crosses the x-axis between, observe that here, minus 1 and 0. In between minus 1 and 0, this curve crosses the x-axis at only 1. So that is the expected real solution of given equation. So thank you.